Hi, this is Graham. Hope everyone's having a great day. Welcome to today's video in which I want to discuss connecting flashes to Panasonic and Olympus cameras. In particular, the ones that are marked or designated TTL compatible. I was alerted to the fact that this particular device, the Mikkei MK300, was available on eBay or on Amazon for about £33 in the UK. Now, on the surface of it, the spec sheet for this device looks quite good. It claims to be TTL compatible for both Panasonic and Olympus cameras. Basically, TTL flash metering means the camera is responsible for determining the exposure. Normally it fires a pre-flash and it uses that light intensity to work out how long the main flash intensity has to burn to give you the right exposure. Later cameras like the FZ200 don't use a dual flash system. They integrate the amount of light coming back and when it reaches a sufficient level, send a pulse to turn the flash off again. So I was concerned that these devices wouldn't maintain compatibility across the two types of flash systems. When you look at the dedicated flash units, and this is the FL36 from Olympus, it maintains complete compatibility between the single flash and the pre-flash versions of cameras, and I'll show you that in a moment. This device, the Mikkei 300, can only accommodate those which use a pre-flash. And there is a caveat to that, they can only accommodate a pre-flash up to, say, the GH3. The GH3 is a new version of camera which controls flash in an optical way using slave triggers, but in groups of particular camera sets. So the actual camera can control four groups and four flashes. I think that is a stretch too far for the compatibility of this unit. I have tested the compatibility of this unit with some of the dual flash system cameras, and that is the Olympus OMD EM5, so that works fine. It works up to the GH2, it works with the G series cameras, and I've tested up to the G5 and they work okay. What it won't work with is the single flash cameras, so that's the LX range of cameras. The LX3 and the LX5 doesn't work. The FZ200 and the FZ1000 doesn't work, and the GH3 doesn't work. It works with the Olympus Pen series, and I've tested that up to the EPL3 model. I'm going to show you what happens with the compatibility mode of this particular flash and why it doesn't work. I'm going to connect it to a camera that it does work on. So I'm going to connect it to the Olympus Pen EPL3 camera. If I turn the camera on, turn the flash on, looking at the LCD display, I've got the mode set to TTL. So that is the flash communicating with the camera. So the camera is communicating to the flash the aperture that it's got set and the ISO. And if I change the aperture, I can see that the aperture changes on the LCD scale and the distance that the flash will respond to also changes. So it is working in that respect. Let's test this flash on a compatible model, and this is the Olympus Pen EPL5. The camera is communicating in a TTL mode. The TTL mode is set on the flash unit. As I change the aperture on the camera, the LCD display changes and also the range at which the flash will accommodate. I've got the flash set to f2.5, so it should be a very fast exposure. If I take that exposure, you notice we've got a very brief pre-flash plus a longer main flash. So the camera is communicated directly with the flash unit to tell it how long that main burn should be and then extinguishing it at the end of that period. So that is working fully compatible. If I now transfer that to the FZ200, which doesn't use the pre-flash system, it uses the integration method. When I connect this flash unit on, it's still in the TTL mode. It is communicating with the camera to tell me that it's f2.8, and if I change the aperture, the LCD display changes, so that's working fine. But you'll notice that even though I've got f2.8 set as an aperture, when I fire the flash, it's just one exposure at full power, so I get a totally washed out picture. The flash wasn't extinguished by the camera saying that I've had enough exposure. So that is the problem of the compatibility mode. I've now installed the Olympus FL36 fully compatible flash on the FZ200. I've got it set to TTL auto. The camera, as I zoom, controls the zoom head within the camera, so there is total communication between the camera and the flash unit. And if I change the aperture, then I noticed that the distance scale is changing on the back of the camera, so we have got total communication. Again, I've set an aperture of f2.8, and you'll notice that I get a very brief flash, and the exposure is perfect. So the compatible flash guns actually can communicate and extinguish the flash when the cameras reach the correct exposure, which isn't the case with the MK300. With the GH3, it uses a different commander system to control remote flashes. So I'm just wondering if the remote flash system in that is affecting the way the MK300 interface works, so you don't get true compatibility with the GH3. If we install it on the GH2, it works fine, because this is just a single pre-flash system and it works fine. Well, that's it for this video. I hope you found that interesting, and I hope it saved you some money if you were thinking of buying the TTL gun from Mikkei, or in fact if you're looking for other TTL compatible units for your Panasonic or Olympus cameras. Just make sure that it will support the mode of camera that you have. Okay, that's it for this video. Thanks again for watching. Until the next one, take care and goodbye for now.